Everyone, and once again, welcome to WS Cube Tech English channel. Myself, Omar Tazkir. As in the previous video, we basically discussed about two types of audience that we can create or that we can work on in our Google Display ads, right? So in our Google Display campaigns. So those two kind of audiences were the detailed demographic audience and the second one was affinity audience. Now, in this particular video, we will be talking about in-market and live events audience and in what situations we should select in-market or live event audience. So this is going to be the topic of this particular video. But before actually diving into the topic and content of this particular video, I request you all to please do subscribe our channel and click on the notification bell so that you do not miss any one of the important videos, right? So guys, let's begin. And first of all, let me again clear you the differences between affinity audience or the affinity kind of audience and in-market audience. So guys, affinity audience is that audience which actually shows some interest or shows some habits into any product or into any service or into any kind of characteristics, right? Whereas in-market audience also is kind of audience which basically shows some interest towards a product or a service, but that interest is for a shorter period of time, right? So whenever I am searching for something, like I am an user and I am searching for like iPhone 11, buy iPhone 11 online. So the in-market audience basically comprises of audience which are actively researching for something or actively planning to buy something. So if we want to target these kind of people who are in-market, right? So they are actually researching or planning for something. So if we have a product or service and we want to sell that product to, or service to a person who is right now looking for those kind of products or services, then we can capitalize on this in-market segment of audience, right? So this is how we can do it. Now let's explore what kind of things are there, right, within this in-market and live event audience. So as soon as we'll be clicking on this thing right over here, in-market and live events, we'll see two sections over here, which is like in-market audience and live events. And let's first explore the in-market audience. So you are having, there is a very huge, super huge audience sets available here from different categories, right? So we can select different audiences from different niche. We got the option of apparel and accessories. So as soon as we will click on this small arrow button over here, we'll be seeing more subcategories within this category, like active wear, right? So if you are selling active wear, if you are selling backpacks, costumes, eyewear, and within eyewear also we have sunglasses category. So there is a very good segmentation of each and every category which is present over here, along with the different, the variations of the interest, right? In market audience interest, this is super huge, right? So we can also target people based on their in market research on jewelry and watches. So as soon as we'll be clicking on this, we have options of fine jewelry. And then again, within fine jewelry, we have necklaces over here, right? So if you want to target women who are interested in necklaces, you can select your gender as women and then you can select necklaces over here, right? So if you have any product which is jewelry kind of product, you can definitely come over here. You can target this jewelry and watches. You can target this segment, okay? You can create a campaign for this segment only, that, okay, I want to reach to people who are basically actively looking for or planning or researching for jewelry and watches. That is what this in-market audience is made for, right? So let's close this thing. And then we have luggage. Then we have men's apparel. We have outerwear, pants, shirts and tops, shoes. And within shoes, we have different categories of the shoes also. Socks, right? And women's apparel. There are so many things, right? So this was only for the apparel and accessories. Now we have different options over here also. So if you are selling some auto vehicles related stuffs, that then you can also target those things over here. If you are selling anything or if you are providing services with regards to baby and children products, you can do that thing also. If you provide business services, this is again a very interesting thing. So if you provide advertising and marketing services, like if you provide digital marketing, that is like search engine optimization or PPC based services, you can target these kind of people who are actively researching or planning for these kind of services. Then you have business technology, you have office supplies related in-market audience, you have computer and peripherals related. So this is totally based on what kind of product or service you are offering, right? So then you have education, right? So again, in education, you have option of post-secondary education, and within that you have different categories, right? So these are kind of a basically different courses that you can target, right? People who are actively planning or researching for these kind of courses. So again, this segment is important for educational consultancies, universities and schools, right? Employment is again important for the people who are into HR industry. Then we have event tickets option, quite good for anyone or who has a business for like they if they have a business like tourism, travels and everything, these kind of audience can be beneficial to them, gifts and occasion. So there are so many things, right? Then we have real estate, and in real estate we have commercial properties who are looking for commercial properties for sale, right? Who are looking for commercial properties for rent. Then we have moving and relocation, that is basically for the businesses which are of kind like packers and movers, seasonal swapping and softwares, sports and fitness, telecom, travels, right? So again, for travel agencies, we have these many categories, okay? People actively looking for the air ticket, air travel, people actively looking for the bus and rail travel, people actively looking or researching about the car rentals. So there is huge scope for each and every category that you can actually target. So this was all about the in market as we went through these options. This was all about the in market. Now let's explore the live events. Live events, their frequency is not very high, just because we cannot say that anyone is getting married again and again in an year or in their life. So it happens only once, or it happens very few times, right? So you can pick those important live events of any individuals, right? And you can get audiences around those important live events, and then you can sell your product or advertise whatever you want, right? So once you have an audience over there, you can show your ads to them. This is the basics, right? So with regards to business creation, we have different live events over here. With regards to job change, we have again different live events. So let's explore these things. This is again a very interesting part. So within business creation, recently started a business, anyone who has recently started a business, now you can think of what kind of consultancy services or product or tangible products they actually require if they are starting or recently started a business, right? These two options are over here. And then we have college graduation option. Like if anyone is graduating soon, they might be looking for some jobs or something. So if we have a job portal, if we provide services, like if we provide HR consultancies or HR related services, we can basically cater these kind of audiences and we can be a good source to them. Then recently graduated. So if you are looking for the persons who are recently graduated, or basically if you are an educational institute, also if you provide some vocational kind of courses for the graduated persons, then definitely you can target these people also. So there is scope for each and every kind of business. So then again, there is marriage, right? So getting married soon, this can be good for banquet and halls, right? And then this one is recently married, so this is again good for like agencies, travel agencies who offer different kind of packages to the couple who have just recently married, right? Then we have moving options over here, and moving soon, recently moved, these kind of options are also there in this live event. Purchasing a home, anyone who is recently purchased a home, then an interior decorator can target these kind of people who have recently purchased a home and now they want to basically decorate their house, or they want to basically work on the interiors of their house. Then an interior designing firm or an individual interior consultant freelancer can target this audience. Now purchasing a home soon, now a different financial institution can basically create the audiences around this so that they can offer them loans or anything like that, right? Then we have retirement based audience also over here. Let's click on this retirement. They recently retired or retiring soon. So you can again understand what kind of audiences these are and what kind of behavior these audiences shows, and then around those behaviors, around those characteristics, you can advertise, or you can figure out basically if you have a product or service and that suits these kind of audience, you can definitely create a display campaign, you can create banners according to that, and then you can show your banners and ads to these kind of audience, right? So guys, in this particular video, we basically explored two other kinds of audiences. These two again are very important, right? So that's it for this specific video. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.